Sabaku Namaskaram. At the outset, let me congratulate Samskruti Foundation for taking this initiative on our culture and our identity. I also like to take this opportunity to thank them for inviting me to speak to this August gathering. What defines, differentiates a nation, a state, a society, a family, to me, is singularly culture. Culture and people, there's a fairly serious interplay between them. Culture uniquely shapes the character and personality of people. All the same, values of beliefs of people shape their behavior, and sum total of behavior of people is nothing but the culture. So values or beliefs are constantly learned by people through formal and informal channels. Be it the family and friends, it can be schools and colleges, it can be the ecosystem and the society. Consciously or unconsciously, each one of us is participating, contributing, shaping in the evolution of culture on a daily basis. The organizers wanted me to speak on value-based interventions in my professional domain. I have to make a disclosure. I'm a first-generation technology entrepreneur. I built a company for the last 20 years, which is global and which we believe is sustainable. Therefore, let me take the next few minutes to share three thoughts of mine. The first one is what I keep saying, values first. I firmly believe that it's important to inculcate the right values and implement them throughout our lives. I'd like to share a few interventions that we as an organization implemented, which enabled us to shape the company as a value-based organization. I always remember a very famous quote which says, our value is equal to our values. We built our company with values as a foundation from day one. We say values first, F-I-R-S-T. We play on the acronym which says fairness, respect, integrity, sincerity, and transparency. These five core values have always guided us and continue to determine the behavior of our actions. Being equitable to the stakeholders, in a corporate world, the four stakeholders I keep talking about is our employees, our investors, our customers, and most importantly, the society, which we believe are the four pillars of an organization, helped us, by being equitable to them, helped us build an organization which created an employment for 15,000 plus professionals in 25 countries across the world. These values helped us an inclusive, transparent, equitable organization and enabled us to prove that we could be successful without compromising on our values. Let me cite an example here, an anecdotal example. The integrity of this company displayed in truthfully deposing the factual sequence of events on an intellectual property litigation in a US court in our formative years made even the US judge trust us and discharge us from this case. Let me move on to the second thought I wanted to share with you today. Education and culture. Education has a significant bearing on culture since it opens up our minds to many possibilities that exist around the world. Therefore, to develop a positive and progressive culture, it is important for us as leaders to enable education to reach the masses. Education and continuous learning play a key role in shaping a person's values and is instrumental for a cultural change. We have demonstrated that intimate relationship between education and learning interventions can reinforce positive cultural outcomes for the society in terms of diversity and inclusiveness. We so far have adopted 25 government schools. This is over a period of last 7 years, and have made several interventions in the school to improve the morals and values, health and hygiene, participation of the girl child, increasing the pass percentage, and the school dropouts. These schools are now equipped with digital classrooms and digital laboratories and digital libraries. On measurable parameters, in these schools, the girl child population has increased from 15% to over 50%. That's what we have now. The pass percentage has increased to 85%, and the school dropouts have decreased to single digits. These interventions have had dramatic impact on diversity and inclusion. Also, interestingly, this is an innovation of our own. After the school hours, the schools get closed at 3:30 in the afternoon. After that, we double up the same digital assets in running what is called as the National Digital Learning Missions, NDLM centers as they're called. And in these classes, the students for us are the age group of 16 to 60 years. And the impact is on 20,000 common citizens every year. So my second message is, many interventions are needed to bring alignment of values. Education is one step in ensuring cultural alignment in society. My last thought that I wanted to share with you is technology and cultural equality. In the last two centuries, technology and culture have significantly influenced each other. Technology developed during and after the industrial revolutions has changed the culture from simple farming villages to modern bustling cities, sprawling suburbs. The mass production of automobiles created a culture of commuters, vacationers, and the suburbs. The promise of technology, especially the new age technology, is that it is a great equalizer that can dramatically transform the way an individual and society function. Technology creates a culture of equality. Our company's vision in terms of applying technology imaginatively to solve the problems that matter greatly reinforces our belief in this aspect. It is built on our awareness of our responsibility to serve unmet needs of the society. For example, we invest in technologies that can help grassroots level people. We're developing techniques to use drones in agriculture that help farmers reduce the use of pesticide by 70% and increase the yield significantly. Here is another great example of technology helps the masses. We have yet another initiative called Engineering the Eye. It's an eye care initiative which we do along with the L.V. Prasad Eye Institute that has helped us in terms of developing a low-cost device for refractive error screening and for early stage blindness detection in low resource schools at remote areas in the country. So my last message is, the technology can be an enabler to bring equality to many and transform the society. So in conclusion, what I want to share with you is that in these three messages I had about, the first one is, if we can certainly bring in culture into our education. The second one is, if we can make sure that we bring in inclusiveness through education, make sure technology becomes a level playing field for everyone, then I think we will be a great nation in future. Thank you very much again for giving me this opportunity.